Hi everyone, welcome back. In my previous video, I discussed how to customize the list view using templates. Now in this video, I'll show you how to load data in the Blazor ListView control using entity framework. First, I need to create a Blazor WebAssembly app using Visual Studio 2019 with the .NET Core hosted application option. Once the application is created, you will notice that it contains three projects: client, server, and shard. To use Entity Framework Core, I will install the Microsoft Entity Framework Core package under the shard project. Along with this, I also need to install the Microsoft Entity Framework Core SQL Server package to use the SQL database in the Entity Framework Core application. Now, let's start on the configuration that need to be done in this application. The first step is to create a model class for the existing database. So under this shard project, I'll add the folder models and create the product details model class with the fields product ID and product name with appropriate data types. Then to connect a Microsoft SQL Server database, I'll create a DB context class called product context and I refer the namespace Microsoft Entity Core Framework. Then add the northone.mdf file. Next, I need to add a class called product data access layer, which acts as a data access layer for this application to consume data. I add the namespace for entity framework, and then I'll define the getAllProducts method to access the products database. The next step is to configure the web API controller to consume data from the data access layer. So under this server project, I'll create a web API controller named products to retrieve data from the product data access layer class using its getAllProducts method. Finally, the ListView component must be configured using the web API adapter. So within this project, I'm going to install the latest Syncfusion Blazor package, add the namespace Syncfusion Blazor list in the imports.razor file. Inside program.cs file, I add the namespace Syncfusion Blazor and add the Syncfusion service to service collection using the add Syncfusion Blazor method. In index.html page, I refer the CSS styles from the installed Syncfusion Blazor package. Then I add the sf-listview tag and set CSS class to list wrapper with border styles to align the ListView component in the output page. I need to assign the data model type class as product details to the tValue property of the sf-listview tag. Then I need to add SF Data Manager to interact with the created web API using web API adapter and consume the data appropriately. To use the SF Data Manager, I'll add the namespace Syncfusion Blazor data and define the SF Data Manager component with the properties URL and adapter. For this URL property, I'll assign the products API controller. Since I have defined the web API controller, let me assign the web API adapter to the adapter property. For this data source, the appropriate data source field should be mapped to the fields property of the ListView component. Therefore, I need to define the ListView field settings tag and map the field product name to the text property. I add the ID property to map the product ID column from the products data table for each list item. Now everything is done. I'll run this application and show you the output. Let's look at the output page. The ListView component displays the product details from the Northone database. And that's it. In this video, I covered how to bind data to the ListView component from the products database using Entity Framework. You can download this working example from the GitHub link in the description below. You can also see if you are eligible for a community license to get a free license key for our Blazor products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this video useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.